चक्षुर्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः पञ्चकौपातरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे You have to let me share the screen.
Already make you co-host, Guru Maharaj.
Okay, just now you did, yeah.
Yes. Hare Krishna Maharaj is Chinese devotee today.
Yes.
Gaurangi Mataji, you will do as a main translation and I will do in the room, okay? Thai translation will be in the room.
Oh, okay. Understand.
Okay.
So we're reading chapter 2, the first stages of devotion. Okay, we're hearing about different kinds of practices by which we can awaken devotion to Krishna.
我们上节课听说了，就是能够唤醒我们对 Krishna 奉爱的，有几个练习。We
heard that there are three different levels of devotional service.
我们听到说，就是奉献服务有三个阶段。There's
devotional service and practice, or sadhana bhakti.
第一个是在练习阶段的奉爱，也就是 sadhana bhakti, 规范修行。
And there is also devotional service in ecstasy, bhava bhakti. And then devotional service in love of God, prema bhakti. So we were hearing about sadhana bhakti, that there's two different divisions of sadhana bhakti.
接下来我们聆听休息中的奉献服务，那么在这个范畴当中又分为两个范畴。So
different kinds of there's a different just like a child learns to walk by practice, the same way a devotee also learns to become Krishna conscious.
就像小孩子学习走路一样。
All right, so reading from the text now. Every living entity under the spell of the material energy is helped to be in an abnormal condition of madness.
在物质能量制约下的生物体，它是处在
In Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, generally the conditioned soul is mad.
圣女伯加瓦坛这样说道，通常受条件限制的灵魂是疯狂的。
He is always engaged in activities that cause bondage and suffering.
他所从事的活动会导致束缚和受苦。The
spirit soul in his original condition is joyful, blissful, eternal, and full of knowledge.
在原本状态下的灵魂是喜乐的，快乐的，极乐的，永恒的，充满着知识。
But because the living entity becomes involved in material activities, he becomes miserable.
但是由于受条件限制的灵魂从事了物质的活动，所以他受苦了。Instead
of joyful, he is miserable.
他并没有喜乐，反而他变得痛苦。
And instead of experiencing eternal happiness, he experiences only temporary pleasure.
他没有体会到永恒的快乐，相反，他体会的只是短暂的快乐。
And instead of being full of knowledge, he's full of ignorance.
他并没有充满知识，而是充满着愚昧。
So he's in this condition because of reactions to his sinful activities.
他之所以被吃他之所以被置于这种状态下，是因为他从事了不应该从事的活动。
Because the conditioned soul does activities which are against the scriptures, so it brings suffering on him.
因为受条件限制的灵魂的从事的活动违背了经典，因此就便导致他受苦。
So, to avoid this, we should practice the principles of devotional service in practice.
为了避免这种状态，他应该练习从事着在练习阶段的奉献服务。
That is called sadhana bhakti.
被称为 sadhana bhakti 规范修习。
And to follow to do sadhana bhakti.To do sadhana bhakti, it begins by offering worship to the deity in the morning, Mangal Arti.
Sadhana bhakti, 规范修
Recording in progress.
是始于清晨早起来做 Mangal Arti, 参加吉祥灯仪
And we have to stop doing different kinds of material activities.
我们需要停止从事各式各样的物质活动。
Things like staying up late at night to watch movies and to watch television, we don't do that.
不应该就是晚上很熬夜去看电影啊，或者是看电视啊。
What we should do, we should wake up in the morning and offer Mangal Arti.
我们应当做的是清晨早起去供奉吉祥的灯仪。
And we should offer obeisances to the spiritual teachers.
要向灵性导师们礼拜。
And there are other different rules and regulations which they have to follow.
还有其他要遵守的规范原则。
I think, can we mute? Yeah, that's good, yeah. Okay, yeah, we have to mute people, otherwise it's too difficult. All right, so, there are certain principles, rules that we have to follow.And that will stop us from becoming mad.
有一些特定的规范原则我们需要遵守。遵守了这些原则之后就会使人不至于变得疯狂。
Just like if a mad person, if somebody has a mental disease, then he has to take medicine given to him by the doctor.
比如一个患了精神病的人必须要服用精神病医生给他开的药。
So then, when he does his bhakti, when he does the devotional service, it cures also the madness which we have because of the maya.
同样，通过练做sadhana bhakti 练修习，这就能治疗我们因为 maya 而导致的疯狂。
Everyone is under the spell of the material energy, that is Maya.
每个人都在物质能量的制肘之下，这就被称之为 Maya.
And the Maya brings us a lot of suffering.
就是由于 Maya 虚幻能量导致我们受苦。
So Prabhupada said, he said, actually, he said, everyone is mad in the material world. And Prabhupada told the story. He said, one time there was this case in the court, and the man was taken to court, and he was asked why he did this crime. So the man said, well, I'm crazy, I'm mad. So then the judge said, get the doctor to examine him and see if he's really mad.
法官就说，那好吧，找一个医生来看一下他到底是不是疯了。
So the doctor came and he examined the man, and then he gave his report to the judge.
医生就被叫来了，医生就检查了一下这个被告，然后就向法官就进行了汇报。So
then the judge asked the doctor, so is this man crazy?
法官就问医生。
And the doctor said, well, as far as I know, and he said, everyone in the material, in this world is crazy. I never met anybody who's not crazy. Guru Mani, Ni Ting Dalama. Guru Mani. Guru Mani?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, we're back, okay. So, did you hear what I said? The judge said, the doctor said, everybody's crazy. I never met anybody who wasn't crazy. So in the material world, everyone, conditioned souls, they're all crazy. All the activities which they do only bring them suffering in the material world. So Prabhupada said, just like a man who's crazy, he can get cured by following taking the medicine of the doctor. So the same way, if we follow sadhana bhakti, then it will cure the disease of material life.
就可以来治疗我们因为物质生活导致的疾病。So
Rupa Goswami gives evidence from the scriptures to support this.
Rupa Goswami 就引经据典来支持这个论点。And
Narada, Rupa Goswami quotes a verse from stated by Narada Muni in the 7th canto, 1st chapter, verse 32.
圣涅伯加瓦坛第七篇第一章十节三十二的话。And
Narada Muni says, is talking to Maharaj Yudhisthira. He says, my dear king, we have to fix our mind on Krishna by any means.
那的牟尼就在这里对尤迪斯蒂尔玛拉说道：“我亲爱的国王啊，一个人应当想方设法将心意专注于Krishna。”
So that is Krishna consciousness.
那被称之为Krishna之觉。
And it's a duty of the spiritual teacher to find out the way and the means for the disciple to fix the mind on Krishna.
灵性阿查亚灵性导师的职责就是想方设法的让他的门徒将心意专注于 Krishna。
Oh, we're getting a big storm here.
Oh.
So, Prabhupada said that is the beginning of sadhana bhakti.
Prabhupada 就说这便是 sadhana bhakti 规范修习开始的，就规范修习。
So, Prabhupada then continues to explain.He says, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given us a program for this purpose.
Prabhupada 继续说道 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就为了这个目的就给了一个授权的项目活动。
And,The program is centered around the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra. The chanting is so powerful that we immediately become attached to Krishna.
念诵是如此有力量，它能使人立即就开始变得依附于 Krishna.
That is the beginning of sadhana bhakti.
那就是 sadhana bhakti 的开始。
Somehow or other, we have to fix our mind on Krishna.
无论如何，一个人必须将心意专注于 Krishna.
And the great saint Maharaj Ambarish, he was a king.But he fixed his mind on Krishna.
伟大的圣人 Amarish Maharaj 尽管是一位国王，却将心专注于 Krishna.
And anyone who tries to fix his mind on Krishna can very rapidly make progress.
任何人努力地试图将心专注于 Krishna 的话。就很快地能取得进步。
And you'll quickly become Krishna conscious.
他能迅速地变得有 Krishna 之觉。
So sadhana bhakti means the practice of devotional service, and it can be divided into two parts.
Sadhana bhakti 意思就是练习奉爱服务，也可以被分为两个部分。
The first part.Is called service according to the regulative principles.
第一部分称为根据规范原则从事的服务。
The devotee has to follow these different principles.
奉献者们必须要遵守这些原则。
He has to follow the order of the spiritual teacher.
他必须要服从灵性导师的命令。
And he has to follow the instructions of the scriptures.
他也需要遵守经典的训示。
And he cannot argue, and he cannot question about why we have to do this. He has to do it without questioning.
他不能争辩，也不能提问题。反驳说为什么我们要这么做。
So that this process, this is called Vaidhi, or regulated devotional service.
这称为 Vaidhi, 也就是规范的奉爱服务。
Means we will do it without any argument.
意思是我们不要有任何争执然后就去做。
But,There's another part of bhakti, of sadhana bhakti. Sadhana bhakti is in two parts, right? So the first part is called Vaidhi, and the second part is called Raganuga.
所以 sadhana bhakti 第一部分是 vaidhi， 第二部分叫 raga nuga。
So raga nuga is the point. It's the point at which one becomes more attached to Krishna.
Raga nuga 指的是，在某一程度时，在某一时间点，人变得依附于 Krishna。
Because the devotee's been following the regulative principles, they become more attached to Krishna.
因为奉献者通过遵守规范原则而变得依附于 Krishna 了。
And they do devotional service with love.
他们怀着爱来从事服务了。
Just like an example is given, a person may be doing devotional service and he may be told to get up early in the morning and do the arti.
有一个例子，一个人从事奉献服务，他得到命令必须要清晨早起来做 Mangala arti.
So worship, to do the deity worship in the morning, this is It's common practice, devotees everywhere, they will do this. They'll wake up early in the morning and after bathing and putting on tilak, then they will do the worship.
神像崇拜是普遍的一个修常见的在全世界各地的常见的景象。奉献者们清晨早起他们会沐浴之后涂上 tilak。
Yeah, and they will offer their different items for the worship, incense and ghee lamp and flower.
他们接着就供奉不同的物品，比如说香、灯、花。
So in the beginning.The devotee will do this because he's been ordered to do it by his teacher.
一开始呢，奉献者呢，是因为有灵性导师的命令才这么去做。
But as he goes on doing it, he becomes very attached. He develops real attachment to doing it.
但是随着他，每天去日常进行这种活动的话，他逐渐就依赖于这种活动了。
And when he gets this attachment, then he will want to do it better. He will want to try to improve the worship.
当他依附于这种崇拜活动之后呢，他就想做得越来越好，增加提高他的崇拜的质量。
And he will try to decorate the deity. He'll bring different kinds of flowers.
他就努力地想方设法地来装饰神像啊，来给神像带来各式各样的鲜花。
And he will bring different kinds of dresses.
他会给神像准备各式各样的服饰。
And he makes different plans.How to serve the deity, how to make nice festivals for the pleasure of the deity. So in the beginning, it's actually he's practicing, he's still practicing. But,Gradually, he will do more and more service. He'll do it spontaneously, without thinking about what's told to do by the spiritual teacher. He wants to do nice service to improve the service.
但是随着他的练习的深入呢，他这种活动就变成自动的了。他就不加思索的就想着怎么去更好的去做好这项服务。
So this is the second part of devotional service and practice, when the service becomes spontaneous.
这就是规范修习萨登的八个体的第二个部分，就是自发的关爱服务。
So in the beginning, it's under the rules and regulations, and then later on, as it becomes more advanced, it becomes spontaneous.
一开始呢是在规则、规范、原则之下，当它取得了进步之后呢，它就变成自发的了。
So Rupa Goswami describes, he gives a definition for the first part, for the Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti, or devotional service according to the rules and regulations.
Rupa Goswami 就对 Vaidhi Bhakti 做了这样的定义，就是在规范原则下的奉爱服务。
And he says, when there is no attachment,or no spontaneous loving service to the Lord.
他说，当还没有依附，或者是对主没有自发的奉爱服务。
And one is doing service to Krishna simply out of obedience to the order of the Guru.
一个人只是因为服从灵性导师的命令才为主服务。
Or is just simply following the scriptures.
或者他只是仅仅是在遵守经典的训示。
Then that kind of service that is called Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti.
那种服务就被称为是 Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti.
Means devotional service according to the rules and regulations.
也就是根据规范原则从事奉献服务。
So the principles of Vaidhi Bhakti are also described in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
圣典薄伽瓦坛一样描述了 Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti 的原则。
In the second canto, first chapter, verse 5.Sukadev Goswami is speaking to Maharaj Parikshit.
在第二篇第一章十节五 ，Sukadev Goswami 对 Maharaj Parikshit 说话。
Maharaj Parikshit had been cursed to die. He had only 1 week left to live.
Maharaj Parikshit 被诅咒在一周之内死去。
So the king was not sure what he should do in the week which he had remaining.
Maharaj Parikshit 不能确定在生命的最后一周该做什么。
So many different great sages and saintly persons came there, but no one could give Maharaj Parikshit the proper instruction.
有许许多多的圣哲，伟大的圣人们都来到了现场，但是没有人可以给他一个正确的指导。
But Sukadeva Goswami, he came there, and he gave his direction to Maharaj Parikshit.
但是 Sukadeva Goswami 来到了现场，他给了国王一个正确的指导。
And he told Maharaj Parikshit, he said,If you want to be without fear at the time of your death next week, then certain things you must do.
Sukadeva Goswami 就说，国王啊，如果你想在接下来的一周之内变得无惧的话，那需要从事特定的活动。
And he said, actually, at the time of death, everybody is afraid.
他说，事实上，在死亡临终之际，每个人都变得恐惧了。
So he said.Then you must immediately begin the process of hearing and chanting and remembering God.
他说你必须立即开始聆听唱诵和忆念神的方法。
And if you can chant and hear Hare Krishna and always remember Krishna, then he is sure, then you are sure to become without fear at death.
如果能够唱诵和聆听 Hare Krishna, 是既忆念着 Krishna, 那么肯定就能在临终之地变得无惧无畏了。
And actually, death can come at any moment, at any time, to any of us.
事实上，死亡是可以在任何时刻对降临到我们任何人头上。
Maharaj Parikshit, he got warning that he would die in 7 days. We don't know when we're going to die.
Maharaj Parikshit, 他得到警告，会在什么时七天之内死去。但是我们甚至都没有得到这种警告。
But we all know one day we have to die, we have to leave the body.
但是我们知道迟早有一天都要死去，都要离开这具躯体。
So we have to prepare for that time by hearing and chanting and remembering Krishna.
所以我们必须要为那个时刻做好准备。来聆听唱诵和忆念主 Krishna.
So Sukadeva Goswami spoke, he gave this instruction to Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami 就给了 Maharaj Parikshit 这条信使。
He told him, Sukadeva Goswami told Maharaj Parikshit that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Shukadeva Goswami 告诉 Maharaj Parikshit, Krishna 是至尊性格神手。
So Sukadeva Goswami recommended we should always hear about Krishna.
Shukadeva Goswami 推荐说我们应当恒常的聆听 Krishna.
He did not say that we should hear and chant about the demigods.
他并没有说我们应当聆听和唱诵半神人。
And the Mayavadis, you know, the impersonalists, they say that you can chant any name.
那些 Mayavadi, 非人格主义者们说，人可以唱诵任何的名字。
They say you can chant Krishna's name or you can chant the demigod's name and you get the same result. It's all the same. They say it's all one.
他们说，无论你是念的 Krishna 的名字，还是半神的名字，结果是一样的。
But we know this is not true.
但是我们知道这不是真的。
According to the Srimad Bhagavatam, we have to hear and chant about Lord Vishnu or Lord Krishna only.
按照正典国家瓦坛的说法，我们应当只是。聆听和唱诵 Vishnu 或者 Krishna.
We give the example, just like if you are in Calcutta and you want to go to Delhi, then you buy the ticket to Delhi. You get different trains, go different places.
我们给出的例子是，倘若你要从加尔各答去德里的话。那么坐火车，你就要买去德里的火车票。
We cannot say, "Oh, it doesn't matter what train you get on. All the trains are the same. They all go to the same place."
我们不能说，没有关系啊，任何的火车都可以去同样的目的地。
But some people say like this. They say it's all one. It doesn't matter who you worship. It's all one. It's all the same.
但是有人却声称，无论你崇拜的是谁，都是一样的，都是一个，都同样。
But Krishna doesn't say that in the Bhagavad Gita.
Krishna 可没有在《博伽梵歌》中是这么说的。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, "If you worship the demigods, you go to the demigods."
Krishna 在《博伽梵歌》中说到，
And if you worship the forefathers, you'll go to the planets of the forefathers. And if you worship ghosts and spirits, you'll go to their planet. And if you worship Krishna, then you can go to him. So it's not all the one, it's not all the same, there's a difference. We have to understand the different, there's different philosophies. The Mayavadis, they say it's all one, and we say it's one but different. Yeah, you go one place, it's different from another place. You can't say everywhere is the same. So Sukadeva Goswami, he's told Maharaj Parikshit that if you don't want to be afraid at death, then you have to hear and chant and remember about Krishna.
So Sukadeva Goswami 就建议说, 为了在临终之际变得无惧无畏，就要聆听唱诵和意念 Krishna.
Why should he only hear about Krishna? Because Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead.
为什么只聆听 Krishna 呢？因为 Krishna 是至尊性格神手。
And Krishna is also Sarvatma, meaning he's the super soul of everyone.
Krishna 也是 Sarvatma, 意思是他是众生的超灵.
And Krishna is also described as Ishwara, the supreme controller.
Krishna 也被形容是 Ishwara.
And he's in everyone's heart. So we have to become, somehow or other, we have to become attached to Krishna. And if we can become attached to Krishna, then Krishna will make us free from all the danger. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says that anyone who becomes a devotee of Krishna is never vanquished. Kunti a priti janihi nami bhakta pranashyati. Krishna told Arjuna, declare it boldly, Arjuna, my devotee will never perish. But other people, they are always becoming vanquished. They're always disappearing. Others, however, are always vanquished. Vanquished means that after getting the human life, they don't come out of birth and death. When we have the opportunity, the human body is a great opportunity, it's a chance to get free of birth and death. But some people are very foolish. They don't make use of the human life.
但是有些愚蠢之人并不善加利用这个机会。
And they don't even know where they're being put by the material nature.
他们也不知道物质自然会把他们投在何处。
They're put into so many different bodies, different conditions in the material world.
生物被置于物质世界各式各样的躯体、各式各样的处境中。
So if we don't develop our Krishna consciousness in this human life, then we will suffer.
如果我们在这具人体生命当中呢，不发展 Krishna 知觉的话，那么定将受苦。
We will remain in the wheel of birth and death.
我们会滞留在生死的轮回当中。
And that means we'll be in the 84 like different species of life.
这就意味着我们是在840万种生命形式当中。
And we'll never know what is our spiritual identity.
你永远不知道自己的灵性身份是什么。
We'll be in so many all different material bodies in the material world.
我们会在物质世界获得种种物质躯体。
And we won't know either we're going to be a tree or a plant or a beast or a bird.
我们不知道自己会投生为一棵树，还是一个植物，还是一个野兽，还是一只鸟。
There's so many different species of life that we will have to go through all the different species.
有这么多生命种族，我们会要经历所有这些生命种族。
So Rupa Goswami says, somehow or other, we have to fix our mind on Krishna.
Rupa Goswami 说，我们要想方设法，无论如何将心意专注于 Krishna.
We have to become very serious.And then we will not become afraid of death.
We 必须变得十分严肃认真，这样才不会恐惧死亡。
And after death, we don't know where we're going to go.
而在死亡之后呢，我们都不知道自己下个目的地是哪里。
We are completely under the material nature, controlled by the material energy.
我们是彻底在自然法则的控制之下。
Only Krishna is the controller of the material nature.
只有 Krishna 才是物质自然定律的控制者。
So if we take shelter of Krishna seriously, then Krishna will protect us.
如果我们认认真真的托庇 Krishna, Krishna 会保护我们。
If we take shelter of Krishna, we don't have to worry about being put into the wheel of birth and death again.
如果我们脱离 Krishna, 就不用担心被放置在生死的轮回当中。
A genuine devotee is sure to go back to Godhead. Krishna says so in the Bhagavad Gita.
一位真正的Krishna 在《国家颂歌》中说，一位真正的奉献者肯定能回归神
者。Krishna says, "Janma karma chame divyam evam yo veti takvataha takvadiham punar janma naiti mamiti sovarna." Krishna is saying, "One who understands the nature of my birth and activities."How they are transcendental. Then when he gives up the body, he never takes birth again.
Krishna 说，谁若了解我显现和活动的超然本质，在离开这个躯体后将不再投生。
Krishna says, the devotee, they'll go back to Godhead.
Krishna 说，奉献者。他们会回归神手。
And it's also, the same thing is also said in another scripture called the Padma Purana. In the Padma Purana, it recommends that we should always remember Lord Vishnu. Remembering the Lord, this is called meditation or dhyana. Dhyana, D-H-Y-A-N-A, dhyana, meditation. It means always remembering Krishna.
他的意思是始终永远记着Krishna。
So we have to meditate with our mind fixed upon Vishnu or Krishna.
所以我们应当将心意专注于Vishnu或Krishna。
And the Padma Purana tells us we should always fix our mind on the form of Vishnu by meditation.
阿德玛普拉纳就建议说，我们要通过靠冥想，始终将心意专注于为什么的形象。
And we should not forget him at any moment.
在任何时刻都不忘记他。
So if you can do that, if you're able to remember Krishna constantly, then that is called samadhi or trance.
如果能做到这一点的话，被称之为samadhi，就是神定。
We should always try to make our activities in our life so that we can remember Vishnu or Krishna.
所以我们应当让自己的生活，塑造我们自己的生活，好让我们始终恒常的意念着Vishnu或Krishna。
Then that is Krishna consciousness.
那就是Krishna直觉。
If you concentrate your mind on the four-handed form of Vishnu or on the form of two-handed Krishna, it's the same.
无论是将心意专注于四臂的Vishnu或是两臂的Krishna都是一样的。
The Padma Purana says somehow or other, always think of Vishnu without forgetting him.
莲花王师兄说，无论如何要永远记住Vishnu，永远不忘记他。So
this is the most basic of all the principles and rules and regulations.
这是所有的规范原则，最最基本的原则。So
when we get an order from the superior to do something. When some superior gives us an order to do something, at the same time, they give an order something which we should not do.
当一位前辈给我们一个训示，让我们去做某件事的话，那么同时他也给了一个禁令。
Just like if the policeman says, drive the car on the left-hand side. So it means you don't drive on the right-hand side. You drive on the left.
做到永远记住Krishna，永不忘记Krishna的话，那么所有的规范原则，那就变得完美了。
This regulative principle to always remember Krishna and never forget him. This applies to all the people in all the varnas and all the ashrams.
这条规范原则适用于所有的社会阶层，适用于所有的社会灵性阶段。
We know there are four kinds of varnas. You have the brahmanas, and the kshatriya, the vaishya, and the sudra.
有四个社会阶层， brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya, sudra.
And then there's also four different ashrams, the brahmachari, and the grihastha, and the vanaprastha, and the sannyasi.
还有四个灵性阶段，真守生、居士、行脚僧、托钵僧。
So the rules and regulations are not only for the brahmacharis to follow, but for everyone.
这些规范原则不是针对于遵守生的，而是针对适用于所有的人。And
it doesn't matter if you're a beginner. You may just be a beginner. You may be a brahmachari, just new, a new student. It doesn't matter. And somebody else may be very advanced. They may be a sannyasi, but it's the same rules for everyone.
不管一个人是一个初习者，一个真守生也好，还是一个非常进步的sannyasi托钵僧，那规则是一样的。So
the principle to remember Krishna and not forget him is to be followed by everyone without fail.
这条要永远记住，至尊性格神手Krishna的原则，任何时候都不忘记他的原则。 是适用于，是每个人都要遵守的。
Okay, so we'll stop here, and we'll ask if there's any questions.
请问有问题吗
？Archana, Neo Wenti, do you have any questions? Are there any questions from the Chinese devotees tonight?
Yes.
Tell me the one.
Somebody has raised her hands.
Okay.
Nara, there are three hands. There are also Chinese questions.
We'll take the Chinese questions first.
Das, 感恩古鲁仁慈的讲课，请问处在 Samadhi 中的圣人是达到 Raganuga 阶段吗 ？Amarish 王是处在哪个阶段 ？Arjuna 也是自发的阶段吗？ 感恩。 So this question is from Das. He said, "Thank you, Guru, for your mercy." My question is that those sadhu who are situated in samadhi, what stage are they? Are they in the Raganuga stage?
Well, we have to see. They may be in samadhi. What kind of samadhi are they in? Some people are in samadhi, they're just simply remembering Krishna. But they may not do active service for Krishna.
在活跃的为 Krishna 做活跃的服务，积极服务。But
they always remember Krishna.
但是他们在始终 永远记住 Krishna.
So, yeah. It may be spontaneous devotion. It may be Raganuga Bhakti.
He continued to ask, what stage is Ambarish Maharaj?
Well, Ambarish Maharaj is a great devotee. He uses all of his senses in the service of Lord Krishna.
Ambarish Bang is a great devotee. He uses all of his senses in the service of Lord Krishna.
Yes.
Next, Arjuna is in the spontaneous stage.
Arjuna is a very good, he's even a greater devotee. The Pandavas are very, very dear to Lord Krishna. They're very, very advanced devotees.
Arjuna is a greater devotee.
Because they have so much love for Krishna. So Arjuna is, he's a very advanced devotee, more advanced, you could say, than Maharaj Ambarish.
Arjuna is a very advanced devotee, more advanced than Maharaj Ambarish.
But devotees don't think, oh, I'm more advanced than this person, or that person's not as advanced as me. Devotees all think I'm very fallen.
但是奉献者不这么讲，不这么比较，说你看那个人他不如我，他但是他认为我特别堕落。So
we try to see the good in other devotees.
所以我们努力看其他奉献者身上的发光点、优点。嗯哼。Yeah. The next one is from Vrindavan Ishwar Devadasi. 如果临终想着你身上呢? She said, if we, at the final moment, if we think about Lord Nishinadev.
Then, see, it's not just think about him, but you have to think about him with love. You have to think about actually serving him.
我不是单纯的想着的问题，而是应该怀着爱，来想着，要想着服务他。So
if you have the mood to serve Lord Nisringadev, then very good, then you can go to Lord Nisringadev's planet.
如果怀着服务的心态想着主尼圣德，那么就可以去主尼圣德的星球。
Okay.
No, but that's all.
Yes?
That's all the Chinese questions.
Okay. Okay, there are three hands up. Okay, so Vrindavan, Oshwa, oh no, we just had her question, right? What about Yogita Sharma has her hand up. What's the question?
Hare Krishna Gurudev, please accept humble obeisances. Gurudev, my question is actually out of the context. I was listening to another class, Ramayan, regarding that. Is it okay if I ask now or later?
Okay, you can ask later. If it's about, what, it's nothing about the class at all?
No, not right now.
Okay, so Yuvati Sachi has a question.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances, all Guru Srila Prabhupada. How can we solve our material problems by spiritual methods? For example, problems in family, problems with money, economic, political problems like this. And how can we see Krishna consciousness in such situations?
Well, yes. Do you want to translate, Sati? Guru Mani? Well, there will always be problems. We have to understand there's always going to be problems in the material world. But if we become Krishna conscious, then we won't be disturbed by all of these things. We won't see all of these situations as problems. You know, there will always be cases where we think, oh, I don't have enough money, or this is not right, or this is wrong. Well, it's very difficult to make the mind steady and to be peaceful. We have to train the mind to remember Krishna. So if we become Krishna conscious, then we won't get disturbed, we won't be shaken by all of these material problems.
因为心意它总是不安不稳的，不平和的，所以我们要训练心，要想着 Krishna， 要有 Krishna 之觉，要不受打扰，如如不动。
All right, so that's the main thing, get people to understand that the real problem is we've forgotten who we are. We're so absorbed in the body, we've forgotten our real spiritual identity. And so we make all of these problems because we've forgotten Krishna. All right, Yuvati Sanchi.
Yes, Guru Maharaj, thank you so much for your explanation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Jolene, you have a question today?
Yes, Guru Maharaj, Hare Krishna. Please accept my humble obeisance. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna, I read that Maharaj Yudhisthira gave up his throne when he was about to retire. And Parikshit Maharaj is also the grandson of Yudhisthira Maharaj. Why is it that is Parikshit Maharaj very young to a point that he did not prepare himself to give up the royal throne? I'm asking this out of ignorance because I do not know how old is Parikshit Maharaj.
Well, I also don't know exactly how old he is, but we know that after Maharaj Yudhisthira and the Pandavas, they retired, they made Parikshit the king. They made him the new king, and they went away to the Himalayas, Maharaj Yudhisthira and the Pandavas, because they had heard Lord Krishna had left the world, and they'd been told that when Lord Krishna leaves the world, then they should also leave, they should go to the Himalayas. So when they got news that Lord Krishna had left the world, then the Pandavas all went, they went to the Himalayas. And before they went, they made Maharaj Parikshit the king. So Maharaj Parikshit was the king for some time. I don't know how many years, but he was the king for some time. But then he got cursed that he's going to die in 7 days. He had a curse put on him, so he had to prepare for his death. But at the time when he's going to die, he already had a grown-up son, because his son will become the king after him.
Okay. Because 7 days is a very short time, Guru Maharaj.
Well,
yeah, isn't it very short?
7 days to yeah, the curse was he would die in 7 days. So he had 7 days warning before his death would come. He had time.
Thank you, Guru Maharaj.
He had time. That means 7 days to prepare for leaving the body. Now for Maharaj Parikshit, it wasn't such a big problem because when he was a young child in the womb of his mother, at that time he was saved by the weapon that Ashwatthama had thrown, the Brahmastra weapon, against the child in the womb. But Krishna came and protected the child from the heat of the Brahmastra weapon. So Maharaj Parikshit had been saved by Krishna when he was a child in the womb. And so later on, he had become the king and he was ruling the world, but then he got cursed. So when he got cursed, he immediately gave up everything and he went and he sat down on the bank of the holy river, Ganga, and he wanted to get instruction about how to prepare for death. And that is when Sukadeva Goswami came and spoke Srimad Bhagavatam to him. So it was arranged like that, that the Srimad Bhagavatam would be spoken to Maharaj Parikshit. Okay, Guru Mani, can you translate
for me? Yes. Parikshit Maharaj, 他在位多少年？是当时 Yudhisthira Maharaj 他在退隐之后呢，他就放弃了王位。因为他们看到五星比听说主 Krishna 离开了这个地球，所以他们就也去立刻就他们也随即就放弃了王位。他们立 Parikshit 孙子 Parikshit Maharaj 为国王，他们去了喜马拉雅山。 然后也不知道 Parikshit Maharaj 他在位多少年，但是呢，他当国王一段时间之后，他就得到诅咒，被诅咒要在7天之内死去，所以他就立刻也放弃了王位，他就去了恒河岸边坐在那里。这对 Parikshit 大君来说也不是问题，因为他在自己妈妈的子宫的时候呢，他就被主 Krishna 的那个形象。 被 Krishna 就救了，当时的他被反射光袭击，主 Krishna 就救了他一命。后来他当上国王，统治那个星球之后呢，他受到诅咒，他得知了这个诅咒的消息之后，他就立刻又放弃了皇位，然后去恒河那里坐在那里，得到训示，为自己的死亡做准备。这个时候呢 ，Sukadeva Goswami 就来了。 这个安排呢，是为了让圣典摩迦瓦坛得以讲述给 Parikshit Maharaj
得以讲述这个圣典摩迦瓦坛。他也被诅咒的时候，那个时候他已经有自己的儿子，所以他放弃他的儿子，他的国王的王位，他的儿子变成国王。Yeah.
当那个 Parikshit 大君呢，他得知自己诅咒的时候，那时候他已经有儿子，他儿子也长大成人了。
Okay, is that all right, Jolene?
Yes, that's all right. Guru Maharaj, thank you for the answer.
Okay, Vaishnavi has a question. Vaishnavi.
Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Sadhana Bhakti is for us is following the four regulative principles, 16 round chanting. And when a person goes to Raganuga Bhakti, then he will still follow the Sadhana Bhakti. Is it like that, Guru Maharaj?
Oh, yeah. Yes. When you come to Raganuga Bhakti, then you still follow the regulative principles. Actually, sadhana bhakti is not just following the four regulative principles, it's doing things like waking up in the morning and doing arti and going to collect flowers and offering flowers to the deity, praying for Krishna and hearing the scriptures, all of this, this is all sadhana bhakti.
Yes,
you still have to follow the regular principles.
Yes,
Guru Maharaj.
But they,
and also Guru Maharaj,
they do it so spontaneously, they don't have to think about following the, it's just so natural to follow the regulative principles. Yes. Vaishnava.
Yes, Guru Maharaj, got it, yeah. Is it like sometimes bad dreams are the reactions of sinful activities? Sometimes I dream like I am about to break a regulative principle, then and in the dream I remember, oh, we have taken an oath not to break the regulative principle, something like that. Yes, Guru Maharaj, I was thinking maybe sinful activities in the past life or some things like that.
Yes, right. Prabhupada said sometimes Krishna is showing us, he said, that if you ever stop being a devotee, then you'll go back to that kind of life. If you give up Krishna consciousness, then you would go back to that horrible life. So Krishna is showing us that this is what, if that you have, just hold on to Krishna consciousness, don't go back to that life again. Horrible.
Yeah, 我们要是停止 Krishna 之觉 放弃 Krishna 之觉的时候 我们就会恢复到以前的这种状态 所以我们要紧紧抓住 Krishna 之觉 而不要回到以前的那种状态 特别可怕的那种活动状态
OK, Yogita Sharma, Mataji has a question.
Hi Krishna Gurudev. Gurudev, you were giving a class on the 10th to devotees from China in the Dham, right? Regarding Ramayana. In that, when you mentioned that Shabri, she said, no, sorry, not Shabri, Mantara, suddenly acted, the way she acted so negatively, so mean, because she was affected by the demigods. I was surprised, Gurudev, because I've watched that program that on Indian TV, that's since years ago. So I had no idea about any of this. So Gurudev, that means she has no negative, she has no reactions, nothing in her karma. She's clean.
I don't know. 原来在听了Ramayana的guru讲的Ramayana里头讲那个女仆，你看那个mantra，她是特别的那个恶心，她给提了特别下贱的建议，但她是受到半神的影响，就是在MTV上，那难道她就是清白的，她没有任何反应吗？
Well, she's certainly a great soul because she's in the pastimes of Lord Rama. And she's directly connected in the Leela of Lord Ramachandra. So she's definitely some kind of great soul. There's something there to be there in the pastimes of Lord Rama. Everyone who's in the Leela with the Lord, they're all great souls, some way or other. Okay.
Would the demigods have any, you know, karmas negative because they were trying to make it quicker? Nothing as such, is it?
The demigods, well, they're taking part, they're arranging for the Leela of the Lord. They're arranging everything for the Lord's Leela.
Okay, nothing bad over here.
No.
Okay, understood, Gurudev. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Archana and Guru Mani, and thank all the devotees. Hare Krishna, have a nice weekend. Srila Prabhupada.